Hi. As a follower of Christ, we're called to be different. What does that look like? You ever thought about that? Is it about how we act, how we talk, how we look, how we dress? Is it about the car we drive or the house we own or the things that we possess? Or is it about the things that possess us? The question is it can be a lot of different things. It's not specifically one thing. It's not about the prayers that we say or, well, the Bible that we read. It's about our life. It's interesting to me when I read the scriptures about what God has called us to be. In fact, in 1 Peter 2:9, it says, "You are a chosen people, set aside to be a royal order of priests, a holy nation, God's own, so that you may proclaim the wondrous acts of the one who called you out of an inky darkness and into the shimmering light." That's pretty descriptive when you think about it. We're called to proclaim his goodness. How do we do that? Well, there's a lot of ways of doing it. Part of the way that we can do that is just how we live, how we talk to others, how we treat others, how we don't treat others. It's not about going to an assembly or to a church. It's about living it every day, out in the community, out in your job, wherever you are, before your family, before the world, and learning to proclaim it. In other words, talking about God in a very natural way, as you would talk about anything else, whether you're talking about sports or your hobby or your children or grandchildren, you talk about God the same way. Here's the thing that I've realized: if God's not doing anything in your life, then you don't have anything to talk about. And so the question is, if he isn't doing anything in your life, what's wrong? What's going on? I say that because I believe that God is doing something all the time. We're just not observant enough. We just don't see it. We just think that, well, God's there and I'm here and, well, once in a while our worlds collide. No, I don't think that's true. I think it collides every single day. And he's called us out of darkness to proclaim light to a dark world. There's a lot of opportunities to do that. And that's not about expounding on your opinion. It's expounding on God and God's word and what God thinks. Now, that doesn't mean that your job is to correct people. Sometimes we get that mixed up, you know. I'm here to correct people. No, that's not what you're to do. You're here to love people. In fact, God said that they will know us by our love. So how do we do that? Well, we need to look to Jesus. Because Jesus loved people. He loved the woman at the well. He loved Zacchaeus up in a tree. He loved people that the religious people didn't. And what we need to learn how to do is love like Jesus loved. Hey, think about that today, would you? Until next time, God bless.